It's your boy Zappa, King of the Giant Robots, and welcome back to Super Robot Wars X.
Ooh!
Not GC. Previously, we learned that the ball can be deployed on Earth. It has a bee in air. It can freaking fly the whole time. I'm stupid. Let's shoot some robots. Stage 12, Odessa Day. Previously? Previous day? Next day? Space. No, the moon. Tsuki. Meanwhile, Diego's empire on the moon. Gildor allows Mayo Plateau to go back to Earth to reclaim his pride by attacking the D-weapons and the White Base again, along with the Black Tri-Stars from the Odessa campaign. Maybe? I'd have to check that against my GC book. Black Tri-Stars are being briefed by Makuve. Uh-oh, that's not right. Yes, it does say Makube. But this is... Alright. They're being briefed by Makube that they are to attack General Rebel's forces, but first... He says they must take care of the White Base. Well, this is not in the translation. There are some additional scenes, like this. Back over here. Oh. I guess the Zeons are still talking shit to one another. More untranslated shenanigans. And now here we are with Shiro at the Federation base having his hearing, defending his actions while he was with Ina. Shiro says that there are good people on the other side, you know, Zeon. Which elicits a snicker for some of the truce as he is ordered to return to the White Base and continue their mission of drawing the enemy's attention. No punishment yet. Elidor is finally recovered from his injury and welcomed back to the team. He asks about Shiro's Inquisition and is told that Shiro got off light, but it's better than being sent to the firing squad. Shiro returns, eventually. Yep. Shiro returns and tells his team their mission will now only get more dangerous as they'll be tackling the best that Zeon and Giganos will throw at them. But they must remember that they are not butchers. And on the other side, there are also human fucking beings. Shapiro hears this and mocks Shiro's point of view, saying that war is where people shed the skin of humanity and become ravaging beasts. They must kill the enemies before the enemies kill them. They must become ruthless. Shiro says that he can't think and fight the way that Shapiro retorts that Shiro will never be able to protect his friends, but Shiro says that he will find his own way. J9 team arrives to say that at least Shiro isn't about to run away from his responsibilities, so this is good. The J9 crew are quote-unquote back, and this time for the long haul, Shapiro says that he will see Shiro's answer on the battlefield then. Finally, J9 is not running away. Kiki's also decided to go back home, since she is Barret's daughter, and she has responsibility back home. She tells Shiro that he's still kind of green, but is extremely good quality, and hopes that Shiro never loses as the war continues. Oh, he has a good quality that she hopes Shiro doesn't lose. Sayla has now been assigned the new G-Fighter, to which Gundam can use as a carrier. Although Sayla tries to refuse, Shapiro brings up the point that Sayla took the Gundam out without permission, which the punishment is actually more severe than a couple of nights in the brig. Shinobu grumbles that Shapiro's always belittling and looking down upon others, to which Shapiro hears and tells the Dankuga team to head out for another set of exercises and practices. Armor is having a talk with Matilda and asks if the White Base has to join in the Odessa campaign. Matilda says that they have to, but she will help out as much as she can. It's obvious that Armor is enamored with Matilda, and she says that Armor's data and ideas on mobile suits are quite good and have been sent to be considered for use. Kimmy brings up that with all the new models coming in, she wonders if they have a new model for her to use as well. She remembers having to go to this, test this and that kind of stuff back home. Barry says that it's all in the works. And Kimmy replies, God, I hope so. God, I hope it's not something weird. I mean, I'm a beautiful female pilot. Come on. Sergeant Ben lets the Dragnar team know that their pilot license cannot be just yet revoked. They have made modifications to the Dragnars to allow them to fly, and they've been given a promotion to a point that they now outrank him, meaning that he's going to have to be nice to them. Tap and the others are actually too depressed to even think about taking advantage of this, but, well... more important shit happens. The Zeons have launched an enemy attack on that mobile suit! Dragon team deploy. Oh man. The lifters are here. Dragon our team deploy, as do the 8th MS team. Kane and the others note that while they're not used to aerial warfare just yet, this is going to be hard, and to see that Shiro has a new Gundam too. Shiro says that it's just his old ground-type Gundam patched up with a couple of modifications. Sayla's not too sure about this, but Matilda reminds her of her crime of taking out the Gundam, and the reason she got off life because they believe she also might be a new type. Mirai tells Bright that the engines are only at 50%, so they can't move just yet. Matilda asks if that's not just Mirai's intuition or something else. Mirai says that that's just how she thinks things are, and only that. Matilda will lend all the support that she can. The enemies are the Black Tri-Stars and Maya Gignos' practice squad. Guy smirks at the Federation's mobile suits aren't all they're cracked up to be, and tells Mash and Ortega to follow him and attack the White Base. Arma realizes this and moves to intercept, only to get surrounded. We're doing it.
Ortega, Mashu, Yasuni jet stream attack をかける。
Matilda moves in to attack, trying to free Armoro from the surrounding formation. But Ortega attacks her in the Medea. Goodbye. Enraged, Armro attacks Mash.
この間合いなら避けられるもんか。行くぞ。この。
楽しませてもらえそうだな。
He's not able to kill Mash and has to retreat before he gets surrounded again. The rest back up Armor, and soon enough the Black Tristars have to be defeated. I get 8. Well, here they are. They have lifters now. Flight backpacks are enabled. S rank in air. And because Shiro's now in the Easy 8, he's no longer in the ball. Nobody is in the ball. How rude. But we have over here Seda Mass. New type level 3, shield defense, and support level 1, has luck, finally somebody else with luck, inspiration, the good old flash, and focus. got tied up. And then here we go. Well, first I'm gonna feed her lots of luck. Get out of the menus. Get out of here, Mashu. Potential level 3. Really? I don't think so. I think one of the games would say as much, but I also don't think I can capture these particular DOMs. I have to wait till later. Bruh! Defending. Ortega. Oof. Black Tristars aren't defeated. Goodbye. And also while grinding, let's see if it'll show up. Our lion friend has gained the SP Ace. That's what you get for spamming the move. Hold on, let me tank up. Lock in. Might as well have Bright use all the SP he can. Damn. Well, that's fine then. And I forgot to show off now that they fly. See if I can't. Oh, Shira hasn't done anything yet. And the hover truck hadn't done anything yet. Skin might be free for the lion, but I'm gonna do five more. I know it's not going to take 50, come on. It's gonna happen. It could have happened sooner, mind you. There it is! Oh, come on! I didn't ask for no sweet nail, bro! Nice! Get him out of here. It's at least a pixel, I don't know if it's one. I already got shooting it. Yeah, it's fine. Oh, left it on. Didn't mean to. Also, hello, Starman. Yeah, scrub. Oh, I do want to leave this one on.
Sora dedekita! Zen!
Hit this wall. I'm gonna start punching their faces in. Damn, I got hit. What? Really? Missed. Oh, I can't capture a goof on this stage. Like, the goof would have to make its way over to the white base, thus putting the white base in danger. Boom. I don't want to punch the hell out of him. Get cut down. Ooh, aggressive beast. And they continue to come for Daniel Cougar like a bunch of idiots. This one though. Nice.
ことないじゃん。人の心を踏みにじるてめえらのやり方は汚すぎるぜ。行くぜ、ダンクンホー。 我らが負けたわけではないのだ。
Damn! Just crush everything in your path. Of course, this is burning out energy, but still. Okay, good. No, that's too much high power. Too much high power, man! Yeah! Get in there. Get popped! Let's decouple. You can heal. That's cool. However, we need to see G Falcon in action by itself. Oh! Didn't mean to do that. Oh well, it be what it be. Back. Aw, damn. Bruh. Which one is this? Which one is this? Shooting skill 8. Shooting skill plus 10, hit plus 5, and weapon range plus 1. Very nice. Left, anybody's left, Daniel Cougar is left. Try. Crunch. Nice. Good hit, Kai. Let's do it. You missed. I missed. Pull up. Couple. Ow. It's not much, but it's money. Let's Axel. Seven. Nine. Okay, that's better. Fucking guts up. So what do you got? You got some focus. Got some lock in. Bless up. What? Fucking rude. Oh man, and I fucking... Aw, that's booty. Mercy's not a thing in this game, is it? Snipers, though. Oh, but here. Shit. Ah. In that case, let's... I need that to reach. Yes. There we go. The Dragon team have gotten better. We'll get them next time. Boom. Who was? Oh. Oh, I forgot to cast luck on that last one. Oh well. Okay, this is where we live now. Shooting ace, very nice. All right, the battle's over. Oh, the battle is over. Bravo tells Bright that the Odessa campaign is ended in victory for the Federation, and the White Base is to move on to its next destination on its trip to Jarbro to deal with any Zeon Giganos force along the way. I forgot to cast luck because I forgot that I had saved before luck and not after it. You saw the struggle. You saw the save scum. At the end of the day, McCoove consoles himself, saying that it was just one battle, but with the resources that Cassilia sent him, Zeon can last for 10 more years. Or so he believes. Meanwhile, Bright tells everyone to salute for those who gave their lives in the Odessa campaign. Akemi wonders why humans have to hurt and kill each other like this. And Sailor regrets not being good enough to help Matilda with armor, shouting out her name in sadness into the setting sun. Thank y'all for watching. If y'all want to see a game where Matilda does not die, please check out my Let's Play of Real Robot Battle Line. Good night, Space Knights.